The Lord said, don't be demanding. So before we say, don't worry, there's an important saying, which is, don't demand. Don't demand doesn't mean don't have natural ambitions. No, don't demand in this sense means don't covet. Do not worry doesn't mean do not care. You have to care, but you should not worry. There's a big difference between having worries and having normal cares. For example, if you're at work, you have to care about your work. That's being loyal. As a father, you have to care about your kids. That's also being loyal. But all that doesn't trigger anxiety. What triggers anxiety are the worries, not the caring. The excessive demands are what cause worrying. So why do you want so much when just a morsel will suffice? Why do you want lots of clothes when any outfit will suffice? Why are you in want for tomorrow? Look, God didn't forsake yesterday. He's not going to forsake tomorrow. So it becomes clear that what causes the worrying is greed, which translates to the word demands. Lots of demands will trigger worrying, guaranteed. Because of this, you'll notice that worrying in the world of the poor is less than the worrying in the world of the rich, even though the needs of the poor are greater than the needs of the rich. Can you believe that? How come the poor do not worry that much, and the rich worry more, although the rich have more? It's because the demands of the rich are more. Do you get the idea here? It's not connected to how much one has, it's connected to how much one wants. The rich want more. He wants the car to be better. The poor don't have a car. So before it says, don't worry, it says, don't covet, meaning enough with the demands. Your father knows what you need, he knows what your kids need, and what you haven't paid attention to is that your kids are in need of repentance more than they need school. And God has left you to focus on school and sports, but he sees that there are other needs that you haven't paid any attention to. They need the church. They need to love God and the Bible. And you're wearing yourself out for their school and sports. No, no, your determinations are backward. Right before this passage, it says, then he said to his disciples, therefore I say to you, do not worry. So I put don't demand and don't worry before don't be anxious. Or rather, Jesus put them in that order. Many demands and many cares of this world will produce much anxiety. Guaranteed. Reduce your demands, reduce your worries, and your anxiety will go down. Because of this, a true monk is free from anxiety. You know why? Because he has no demands in his life and he has no worries. The monk that does it correctly, he has nothing in his life. Self-imposed poverty means that nothing belongs to him. So if they take it from him, they take it from him, no big deal. It's not his. Even his clothes are not his. He has nothing at all. The moment he stepped into the monastery, they told him this. So if his brain is programmed correctly, he can't worry. If something gets stolen, it gets stolen. So what? What could be stolen from him? He owns nothing for it to be stolen. We remember a weird story. Monks were praying Tezbeha, the midnight praises. Then they heard that there was a robber in a cell in the monastery. So a monk came to the head of the monastery while they were praying Tezbeha, and he said, Father, there's a thief stealing stuff in the monastery. He told him, what's your job? The monk said, I'm a monk. He said, what's his job? The monk said, he's a thief. He said, let each one do his own job. You know, so the monk's job isn't to be a robber, it's to be a monk. So just pray. By the way, this story is true. These monks couldn't care less. They are accustomed to not having. Because for them, having is the same as not having. From the very beginning, we have died by choice. So we died by our own free will. If you want us to die, we die. If they take our food and we die, we don't have any problem with that because we agreed to die from the very beginning. And anyway, when they take the food, God will give us plenty more food and he will prevail. So don't demand, don't worry, don't be anxious. These three come one right after the other like that. Say it with me. Don't demand, don't worry, don't be anxious.